ladies, welcome back to my channel. Today for you, we're doing a back to school supplies list, purge, and organization. I'm gonna show you from beginning to end in detail how to get your school supplies ready for back to school. I'm a mom of four and I homeschool two older kids. So I have to stay organized, have a plan, and know exactly what I'm gonna do so things don't fall apart. Because needless to say, it's a circus up in here. I'm doing a whole back to school series on my channel. So don't forget to subscribe, hit the little bell notification so you're notified every time I post a video. If you feel like depositing some positive energy into the universe, give your girl a thumbs up. I would so appreciate it. It helps out my channel. If you want to be the most organized mom on the block and have all your school supplies ready to go, then just keep watching. Supplies. Now, I don't know about you, but when I was a kid, I absolutely loved school supplies. Okay, let's be honest. I'm pretty much obsessed with school supplies to this day. I mean, I have boxes and drawers and all kinds of things filled with stuff that I'll probably never get the chance to use, but they're cute, they're fun, and functional if you actually get the opportunity to use them. But I love school supplies. So, I like to prepare and not overpurchase because, like I said, I have a lot. So what I like to do is have a list and I like to have a plan. I like to purge, get rid of things that we're not ever gonna use. I mean, I'm gonna try to purge as much as I can. I feel like purging is super important. You know, old markers, erasers that, you know, pencils that don't have erasers. I mean, not that you can't use them, but you know, on the list that you're gonna make that I'm gonna show you guys in a couple minutes, you know, you can say eraser ends or whatever it is. But I like to purge through everything in my entire house, even junk drawers, whatever it is. I wanna know exactly how much stuff that I have, which it's a lot. I might be like a baby hoarder, I'm not sure. But anyways, I basically go through everything. I have a cabinet where all of my kids keep their school supplies, all their homeschool books and everything, so I go through all of it. And you know, when you're purging, I think you should think of, you know, can this be reused? Do they wanna reuse it again? Are you willing to purchase it? You know, I think that's a good place to start thinking about the things when you decide to purge. Can this be donated? I like to set up three bins whenever I'm organizing anything. Toss, donate, and keep. So that way I have three different piles, everything set up, and I can just distribute them accordingly. What I like to do while I'm purging is take all of their artwork that I really think is beautiful and I screenshot them, and I like to make a book out of it. So it doesn't clutter the house and start taking over, because it can do that when you have four kids. After we're purging, I kind of do it while I'm purging, but you know, this would be the second part. So I start taking inventory, okay? So I literally write down everything that I have, you know, two boxes of pencils, two backpacks, whatever it is, I lay it all out and I get a good idea of what my inventory is. I even go back in like old bins of like school supplies and stuff that I haven't pulled out. And you know, it's a good time to start deciding if I need to add more stuff, you know, as I'm doing this inventory to that donation pile. Will we reuse it? If not, there's somebody out there that would love, you know, that could use these items. So I would definitely, as you're doing an inventory, think about again in this step what you could further purge. I read this book called, I believe the book is called The Art of Tidying Up by KonMari. And it's a very popular book that floats around YouTube. But if you guys don't know what it is, it's basically a book that tells you to only keep things if they spark joy or you actually use them. Anyways, so go through everything and just again decide what could you really get rid of. And then if you're gonna keep it, mark it down on your inventory list. Okay, so now that you've written down an inventory list, now it's time to start writing down things that you're going to need. Now I understand school has not started, you know, if your kids are older or there's, you know, they're in high school, junior high, teachers have requirements. So I feel like if you get the bulk, you can definitely purchase those after school starts. This is gonna make it easier so you're not stressful, things run out, the cute stuff runs out especially, and you know, that's important. Hello, you wanna go to school with cute stuff. Okay, so what I like to do is I made this school supply list. This is a printable available down below in a link. but I basically put the item and quantity, okay? And you know, it's a very simple list, but I think it's good to just have everything written in one place. I like to look and see what maybe sales are coming up. I do a lot of Ebates. Ebates is amazing. So if you're not using Ebates, oh my gosh, I just called it Etsy a second ago. If you're not using Ebates, there's something wrong with you. I'm telling you right now, it is literally the best website. It saves you money. You get cash back on your own purchases. There's no cost to use it. There's no catches. I thought that there was, but there's not. You basically go there. Like, let's just say I'm gonna go to Target. You go to the Target. You type in Target, it takes you to Target, and then whatever you purchase, it gives you cash back. You have to set it up and all that, but girl, it's worth it. You have to get this, trust me. I've gotten back with up to $500. They do it for Saks Fifth Avenue. I've done it with designer purses. Like, this is definitely a hack. And then they have specials too. Like, sometimes they'll do like 10% or like, you know, instead of their normal five, they'll double it. They'll have triple cashback days. I mean, it's amazing. So anyways, get on Ebates. It's a good place to look for back to school shopping, clothes, supplies, whatever it is. It's a great place to start. And then you plug all that in and then you get cash back. So if you're on a budget, I would highly suggest it, or even not, you just want to save some money, okay? After we start making the list, like I said, we start shopping. Hello, best part. So the last step besides shopping is my favorite step because it's organization. So if you guys follow me, you know I love organizing. And basically we get all the bags, we dump everything out, we split things up, we put stuff where it goes, and basically get organized so it's all set up and accessible for your kids, in this case my kids. And so they have things and they're easy to grab, easy to use, easy to find. And then what I like to do is give my kids a little tour. And I like to show them, okay, this is where this goes, this is where you'll find this, and you know, get some feedback from them and see if there's anything, you know, they want to switch around or would be easier for them. So here's most of the stuff that I'm keeping from last year. I'm going to set that aside and show you guys this container. I don't like it. This is what we used last year. It's just a little bulky. It was hard for my daughter to get it out of the cabinet. And I just say, if it doesn't work, let it go. So I decided to work on a new system, which I really think it's gonna work well. It's a toiletry bag. And I love this idea because there's so many different like compartments and zippers and things you can use. I got this one for my daughter and it just got so much space for everything and I absolutely love it. What I like to do is take little bags to organize things by category within inside the bag. Now I'm just gonna be loading everything inside these little bags. First, I'm gonna do markers. I got two different packs this year, the bright colors and the classics. And now I'm gonna be putting them into the different compartments within the bag. So I think about putting them where the stuff that they're gonna use the most, basically. So then pencils, I like to keep those up front. I do the tips facing up. And then these are a few from last year I'm picking out, but she loved these ones. Okay, so then we have these Twister crayons. My kids love these, mostly my daughter, but I'm sticking those up front. She likes to use those quite often, so I keep those in the front pocket. Then I'm gonna do colored pencils. She didn't use these as much last year, but now that she's going into second grade, I feel like she'll definitely be using colored pencils a little bit more. So I'm gonna stick those on the back side of where the pencils are. And now I got these pack of highlighters. I'm gonna just start separating these and splitting them up. One pack for my son, one pack for my daughter. And then I'm gonna take the glue sticks, make sure she has glue sticks available. And these really cool things I got from the dollar store for reading. Then I'm gonna add her markers. And then I'm going to put the highlighters in another individual bag. So next I'm gonna take these eraser ends and I'm gonna stick these in here. They'll put them on themselves.
and just so they have some extra erasers. Now my kids use a lot of dry erase markers, so I'm gonna stick these in there as well. These are just gonna be loose because they use these a lot. So those will be ready to go for them. And that's pretty much how we organize all of our school supplies. I love it. I think it's gonna turn out amazing
for this school year.
So anyways, that's the bag all loaded up. I think it's gonna turn out amazing. I'm super excited for them to try this system. And this is me just putting everything in for Roman. I thought it'd be fun if I did a time lapse for you guys. Now next, I'm gonna be showing you our table that we got from Amazon and how we set everything on it during a school day. So basically, I got these cute little things from the dollar store. They have their name and their nickname and their computers in front. This is what they use the most. I have their planner, then their new school supply system and bag. I just flipped it open because this is what it would probably look like during the school day. I have their iPad. They use this every single day for apps. And then they have their binders and different books. So this is pretty much how they would be laid out. They're pretty spread out here, but it really works for them. I like them to have enough room and it works out amazing. All right, so here is the cabinet that we store everything inside. I just thought I'd give you guys a little peek.
Thank you guys so much for watching my back to school supplies list, purge, and organization. I hope you guys can take some of these tips and tricks and help you get organized this back to school season. It means so much to me that you guys are here on my channel and you've made it to the end of the video. All of the info is gonna be in the down bar below, as well as any product links and the link to my new website. So go check it out. It has everything in it, including all of my favorites in one place. So if you haven't done so yet, subscribe, hit that little bell notification, give your girl a thumbs up. So where do you guys shop for school supplies? Is there anything that you guys think that I need to have for my homeschool or my kids for back to school? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you guys again so much for watching. I truly appreciate it. Until next time, I'm always your girl, Lauren Marie. Bye.